Right.
Now streaming exclusive Disney Plus.
I didn't even bother to take.
Okay, we're losing customers.
What you need, boss? Some wheels? I can bring them around.
That was the wrong one. Oh, where is my car?
I'll get back to it then.
Oh.
Morse Mutual, how can I be of service? I think we can handle that.
What you want? Some wheels? Where's my car? I don't see it nowhere. No freaking way.
Okay, I got stuff to do.
Okay. My friend on here anymore. No.
You're through to your garage. You, need me to bring you a ride? I'll bring it by.
Come on, dude. I'm close to this one. Fuck is on the moon. Oh.
Oh no!
No! I did not mean to do that, bro. Yo, and it was in hover mode at that. Are you kidding me? Bro, that just pissed me off, man. Gosh, man. People need to be on speed dial, like, for real. I lost the truck for sure.
How can we help you?
Yes. Okay.
I'll do my best.
Like, I'm gonna promote this club now.
Sorry, I can't get there at the moment.
Man, for real, dude? Are you kidding me? I don't have to call him. I can just do this. What? That's weird now. I can't request my personal man bump. Hit this. Hey, can you guys bring that battery?
On the Leon Lust channel, we've made an effort to celebrate.
Yeah, I know I'm going to have to wait about 15 minutes. I don't care.
Conditions, if you compare it to societal norms. For example, we had the German woman that wanted to get married was 747. Then there was Philip, who wanted his girlfriend up to 1,000 pounds to turn her into his very own adipose playground.
I love her fat. Under her clothes. Donna's body is a fat lover's playground.
And we can't forget my friend Andrew that married a dog.
My name is Tony, and I'm a human cop.
I'm Andrew. Mm. I'm Tony's husband and trainer.
Or more specifically, a female that became a man to then role play as a dog.
That is so weird. That's so weird.
Okay, well, that was horrifying. So as we continue the celebration today, we do so understanding that sometimes peculiar relationships can be funny. Like when you post up on your girl's computer chair and act as her footrest while she's typing up emails.
A couple every single day, to be honest.
I mean, that shit is kind of funny. But we also do it with an underlying theme of love and support for people unabashedly living their truths, being themselves, loving one another, not worried about what the world thinks, even if it's a little bit different than the norm. And let's be honest, the norm, not working out so hot, right? 40 to 50% divorce rate. I mean, maybe they're on to something, and we're just trying to catch up. And quite frankly, how two consenting adults get on with one another.
Metro Card 507
in the next room to tell us about it.
John, we're ready for you.
Okay, thanks, weirdo.
Well, welcome back, guys. Once again, we're here with the Raycon Everyday E25s, but we are joined this time by this cozy-ass fireplace right behind me. Raycon continues to be my preferred choice for a quality earbud that comes in at half the price of other premium brands. They are stylish, the bass hits, and they're discreet. So you're going to be the flyest player in the room, or should I say, for your next day at homework meeting. 6 hours of playtime, Bluetooth pairing that is a dream, and a noise isolating fit that comes in multiple colors. It's a fat, heavy W. I use them all the time. I work out in them. I poop in them. I even poop in them by the fireplace when the air conditioning in the house gets too cold. By the way, the case charges them on the go. I've gone weeks without ever having to plug these in. So if you're due for an affordable pair of true wireless earbuds, look no further, because right now they're offering 15% off an already affordable price if you use my link in the description. That's buyraycon.com/LeonLush for 15% off. Get your very own pair today. I love you. Thanks for watching.
I'm Madame Posh. And this is Bound Mystic.
Hi,
gentlemen. And welcome to the
MP experience. So here we have Madame
Posh,
Bound
Mystic. Just an absolutely lovely couple. She's a professional dominatrix out of Arlington, Texas. And it'll say exactly what he, judging by the fact he calls himself Bound Mystic, I'm more on the dice to say he's like a professional dungeon master.
So far on this
that
is messed up. Wet fart 989. Oh my God. Weird name.
she knew what she wanted, went out and got it, instead of sitting in her house and crying about it on Twitter.
Hey, how are you?
I'm just going to say this, and I don't mean it negatively. Many times I talk about my wife's resting bitch face on my second channel. If you watch that, you know what I'm talking about. But my dude here, this is like resting this woman's face. Counterbalanced how
oh my god, new boat. He is crazy.
This is typically your foundation for your rope suspension.
It's
going to be your chest harness.
Is this part of the tying is more being more observant of what she's doing?
No, this is stupid. Yeah. No.
So things I notice is that.
Call of Duty with the boys. I like to get dubs in Warzone. I like to go to the water park and have a couple Mai Tais by the pool before smashing a few rounds in the wave pool. Bound Mystic likes to get tied up with rope and hung from a hook like he's a map decoration from Diablo 3. All of these are amazing experiences. It just depends on who you ask.
Seeing this.
Madame Posh knows that it's not about what you say to someone. It's about how you make them feel that leaves a lasting impact, which is why Bound Mystic was her client first and is now her voted subservient slave / partner, and they are happier than any couple I've ever seen, quite honestly. Like, if you were to ask me, hey, Leon, who's happier, the Ace family or Madame Posh and Bound Mystic?
No doubt in my mind that these two are sleeping better at night than the Ace family.
And he talked and talked and talked and talked and mentioned how many times that he didn't understand why people would really be into rope. And then about halfway through taking the rope off, he was like, oh, now I get why people might like this.
Don't knock it till you rock it. Or should I say, don't nope it till you rope it.
I'm going to let him process for a few minutes, even before I start taking the rope off. He's going to get the shivers. That's the aftermath of an adrenaline rush. Like,
Why am I doing this? Intoxicated? Why are you sure that's not just a
side effect of, like, thoracic asphyxiation? I mean, if you're the expert, I'm gonna leave it to you. I'll trust you on this one.
Typically, before I can even get the rope off, I have to leave.
My dude look too happy. He's probably about to lose this anyway. Oh, this is not gonna go well. It's not gonna go well. Already off to a bad start. If I didn't crash into that freaking building. Are we going in a freaking circle? No. Oh my god. No, boy. That is, if I would have just stayed still, I would have been fine. I know I'm in last place. Thanks a lot. Flashing it all in my face. Man, I didn't know what was happening. I probably could have fell down and been alright. Oh, come on. Don't crash. Oh my god. There's only two laps of this. These are the worst cars for this too. Yes, dude. Oh my gosh, bro. Back up. What the heck is going on? Homeboy, you move out the way. Man, bunk this, man. Yeah, this ain't going fast. Yes, I know I'm in the wrong way. Home dude is struggling too, just like me. What? Why is the freaking car breaking? The car just braked itself, and I didn't press anything. This is some freaking bull. Yep. Are you kidding me right now? This car is just automatically breaking. Oh wow, are you kidding me? What? Why did it send me back in the tube? I was out the tube. Oh, come on. Already in last place. I don't care. I'm gonna finish this. Ugly looking car.
This
Dude. I helped you, by the way. It would have been a lot easier if I didn't have to freaking... Come on, didn't you just go outside the freaking door? Why did you lock yourself out? Man, that was all one freaking lap. Very 1921 enters first. That's great. Oh, yeah.
You are the one who made this real for me.
This is beautiful, right?
Oh my god. This is the most romantic date I've ever been on.
Here's to a love story.
I think I might be falling in love.
It's exactly what I always dreamed about.
Yeah. Oh, man. Yeah, I'm putting a freaking thumbs down, too. Dude, man, that was terrible.
My name is Christy. I'm 41 years old. I live in Chicago, and I'm currently single.
Thank you so much. I made the difficult decision to file for divorce 6 months after standing at the altar. And I felt like I was never going to get to have my own family.
Come on, Christy, stop it. You're going to have a family someday. That's why you're on this show. I mean, statistically speaking, it's probably just going to be you and your kid, because after the press and the 15 minutes of fame dries up, Dad's gonna fly back to LA to continue pursuing his acting career and indulging in his weird habit of getting drunk on Chardonnay and texting dick pics to 20-year-olds, but that's still family, technically. I know that was a little aggressive. I really do want what's best for Christy. I truly wish nothing but happiness for her, but shows like this, I just do not trust them.
I'm definitely a little anxious about my test results.
Yes.
I mean, at 41?
The devils look very good. Better than your chronological age.
So there's hope.
There's hope. So we get to know Christy a little bit, then she heads to the fertility doctor, and the doc's like, hey,
yo, I'm not doing this. No, no. I'm not doing this. I'm not doing that one.
And then they ship her off to Atlanta, they pack her into a Tesla, and they scuttle her up to this weird mansion in the middle of nowhere where I'm sure the 15 men will be battling like gladiators for her to become the womb that carries their child.
I'm freaking out. I don't know if I should say this, but like, Charlotte was my...
When she meets the host and just freaks out about how she's Charlotte from Sex and the City for a while. Like I said, she's 41, obviously a huge Sex and the City fan. If you're under 30, you probably have no idea what I'm talking about.
I'm Marcus. I'm 39 years old. I'm an anesthesiologist.
I'm Trent. I'm a instructor. I've got a huge family. Having three older sisters has made me like the woman whisperer, but I'm...
I don't know,
like,
you're not putting the teller
so
on.
So the pros start rolling in, and it's just one handsome chat what? After... There is enough chiseled jawlines and expensive suits in this crowd to make even Dwayne Johnson
feel insecure. It needs a charge.
I imagine this is exactly what a GQ men's calendar shoot would look like.
We got the token small town southern boy. I'm Jason. I'm from
Huntersville, North Carolina, and own my own flooring and renovation business.
The former professional wrestler that you can tell is 5'3 just by looking at his face. I'm Matt. I'm a former professional wrestler. That's me with my dad. When I was 7 years old, my dad asked me if I wanted to see something.
Neighborhood. Mr. Hot, explosive, and intense.
Yeah, I can be explosive. I can be hot sometimes. But I'm quick to every... The women who like me because I'm intense.
And obviously a guy from Queens.
Business in healthcare. I'm the kid from Queens with big dreams.
Maybe it's just me, but I don't think I've ever seen a reality without some dude from Queens. They are like to reality shows what chewing tobacco is to baseball. And there's a bunch more, but my guilty pleasures here, okay, if I'm being honest, are Gary.
I'm Gary, and I own my own company making baseball bats.
Baseball bats, Gary? Frick. Makes baseball bats for a living. What an absolute long dick legend this man must be.
Oh,
you're
my
watching
God.
This right now. You can't look me in the eye and tell me that you know somebody or know somebody that knows somebody.
What?
Makes baseball bats for a living. That is a one in a billion. Gary is absolutely precious. I hope this man wins.
My name's Stuart. I'm the CEO.
Hi, I'm Gary. I make baseball bats for a living.
So you obviously have the tall alliance going on over there.
Like, we'll be like the short blazer alliance right here.
And my personal favorite of the bunch.
What's up, man? How you doing?
Budge. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you as well.
What? Did you say Bud?
It's actually Budge. Right?
Oh, Budge. Oh, okay. I'm sorry. As in, I'm trying to roll over this hippopotamus, but it's too heavy and it won't budge? Like that kind of budge? Fuck, yes, I love this guy.
My name is Budge. I'm a conservative man with morals.
My name is Budge.
Hopefully be a father. Have a cocktail.
And he's straight edge and not giving in to the obvious pressures of this awkward situation? This is the man you want to raise your child because you know that when push comes to shove, when that baby is born and shit hits the fan, he's not gonna budge. Budge. He will not even budge.
Oh my God. The pun.
Welcome, gentlemen.
Me?
Good. Yes.
Yay.
So finally, Christy shows up, comes down the stairs, all the dudes collectively pop a chubby, and then there's
my
a little bit of
ugly.
Sorry.
Are you guys comfortable sharing with me what kind of made you decide to say yes to this?
I was like, you gotta like open yourself up one day, and so like I'm here to take that giant
leap. Oh my God, open yourself up, I'm here to take that. That is so what? That was not smooth.
Part of this process is not figuring smooth. Out if you're all fit enough to be fathers.
Oh my God.
That is so smooth.
Y'all are ruthless.
Oh my goodness.
Okay. Everybody needs to.
Please. Dude, wasting no time right now. I mean, the dudes showed up, they mingled, they sized each other up, they met Christy for like 10 seconds, and then boom! Right off the bat, they're unzipping their $1,500 Armani suit pants to J.O. into a specimen cuff. Classic reality, isn't it?
Those are specimen cuffs.
I did not see this coming, no pun intended. I tell you, I just cannot let a good pun go to waste. God.
Raise your hand if you have done something like this in the past 5 days.
And what's today?
What's today? Oh, man. Yeah, right. Oh, it's coming my way. Okay, cool. Oh my God, why? That is messed up, bro. Black dude. Oh my God, but... Making babies, raising babies. Super cool.
Jason was really drunk at the party and definitely didn't give off the best first impressions.
Facts.
But the Jason I'm talking to you tonight, I could see him being father material.
Yeah, like your father material when they're sober. And then they all drink the whiskey and come home and beat the wife and kids. Seen it a billion times. You really cannot trust somebody until you've seen how they handle themselves when they're hammered. That is a fact. All right, well, maybe you can try to a friend or something, but if you're trying to put him on the fast track to become the father,
all right, we've got
it. Jesus, they're all trying to pipe you down.
I know you don't got no tank, bro. Me up here.
So finally we're getting towards the end of the show and we arrive at what's like the rose ceremony, except this time she's on a iPad that's linked up to a TV that all the guys can see that are in a separate house, and she's just in there dragging their profile pictures to like the keep or the not keep or like need to chat with, and they're all just sitting in the room getting to watch it. Just absolute. So I'll spare you the drawn-out sappy ending to the episode. Basically, she sends one of the old Jets home because he's boring.
I don't see us starting a family together.
You're boring!
It's unfortunate, of course, that we couldn't communicate a little better.
Unsurprisingly, Philip gets heated.
You were one of the guys here that I was most looking forward to getting to know. I just don't feel like we're on the same line.
See us starting a family together. Moonrock trick, idiot. Stuart gets head faked because she invited him to the chat just to tell him how much she appreciated how nice he was to her.
Stuart, as you know,
haha, I'm a sharp soda, baby. Yeah, can we skip the commentary? Like,
about work.
On the Chow Praya outbreak.
But not here.
What's the plan? You always have a plan.
Is there a room in the back or something? Cool. I'll get set up.
Oh my god. Someone really made a movie. Oh my god. For the coronavirus.
So,
save and fail. I'm able to connect to Rockstar Game Service. What?
Well, that's clear. It's not me you're going to be helping. And I want it understood that I am not involved. Just a bystander doing a favor. And this is not an offer of employment so much as an opportunity. And, well, anyway, that's just getting a bit technical.
Yo, am I not in here?
Sometimes our fair and legal justice system makes mistakes. And this is one such time. Here he is, Professor Maxim Brashkovsky. You know the professor? Used to be head of research for the army. 3 doctorates.
I am
overconfident polymath, vain sociopath, tedious egomaniac, control freak, geneticist, weapons development, engineer, car nut, but definitely not a people person. Accused of espionage along with everything else. You don't remember? Well, lucky you. Exceedingly vain and self-absorbed man, brilliant in everything he does. Yada, 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 makes you want to puke. He's a goddamn traitor. I mean, he's a rat, but he pays. Incarcerated for a crime he did commit, but, well, let's just say money talks and he's going to walk. So, we got a few things to get ready, all pretty straightforward. Do them one at a time, but any way you like. Standard op for a gov fact breakout, if you know what I mean. Rad. All right, first thing's a plane, then we got a bus, and then, well, two things. We got the inmate transfer schedule and Rashkovsky's car. More on that later. Let me show you. We need a plane to get the professor out of the country. It's currently being used to traffic drugs by a transnational street gang.
I already know how this works.
Bus. Need a standard Bolingbrook transport vehicle. The least traffic is on the route from Palito Bay. All right, that's where you're going to be able to get a hold of one. You can get a hard copy of the inmate transit schedule at the LSPD's Mission Row station. Go in unarmed, play it cool. You might not have a problem. That's a two-person job.
Yo, my dude looks beat.
The other two-hander is our guy's prize Casco. We believe it's about to be shipped to Korea by a luxury car theft ring.
Oh.
Okay. Mr. Kress said you guys are at least semi-competent, so, well, Professor Rashkovsky pays well.
Yo, why that dude rubbing his fingers like that? What's up with that? Look around. Zoom. Yay.
Sometimes, oftentimes on this channel, we talk about the YouTube undesirables. The liars, the cheaters, the manipulators, the scumbags, the assholes, doing anything and everything they can to get that extra view and make a quick buck to shove in their pocket. But today's video is not really about that. Today's video is about a YouTuber who seems like a very genuine, down-to-earth, reasonable guy.
Waiting for the hope. This dude loves to smoke cigarettes. Who loves to smoke cigarettes nowadays? It's so unrealistic.
This is a premium non-filter cigarette. It's priced differently.
This is crazy.
The Lucky Strike, or Camel, or Pomo. It is on the more expensive side. It's a Philip Morris product rather than R.J. Reynolds in the Arcane set.
Now, reviewing things is nothing new on YouTube. Everything you can possibly imagine is being reviewed on YouTube. It's one of the biggest genres there probably is. Product reviews, electronics reviews, clothes, video games, movies. You could go on for hours.
All right, let's get this done. Yo, on YouTube, why my character not moving, bro? There you go. Get your own ride.
So, you're moving on the plane. It's at McKenzie Airfield. Logistics.
Oh, I'm already bumping into it.
Go in how you like, but go in with a good supply of ammunition, armor, and maybe even explosives. It's gonna get kinda heavy. Like I said before, the airfield is under Vago's
off to the left side. He was all in the way, that's just fine.
That means it's already set up to take Rashkovsky out of country.
Oh my god, move out my way. Lift the smoker. Watch those buggy.
Most of the Vago's upper management is shot callers, if you like, are already incarcerated here in the States and throughout Central and Latin America. They run the network on cell phones, and it's a relatively flat hierarchy at the top. So if you cut one head off, there's six more ways to bite. Not that I want to dismantle any criminal networks.
Nothing. Think about a cigarette.
That's like doing my homework. Criminal homework.
Cigarettes in my life.
Thanks, guys.
Oh my gosh, bro. Yo, why is it? Am I driving for it? I don't even understand it, man. I cannot get myself together.
Manufacturers are given like 10-15% of the space on the front.
You
side,
kidding me,
back,
man?
Back,
after all of that, man. After all of that.
Warnings that you're gonna die. Nick the smoker don't give a shit. Nick the smoker wants a cigarette that's got some body on it.
12 milligrams of tar, 1 milligram of nicotine, and 10 milligrams of carbon dioxide. So this is a nice full friend, if you will.
Tar, nicotine, carbon dioxide. Talk about flavor. I just find this shit so crazy. I mean, this shit is poison, and 1 in 5 people are just sucking these down. I got friends, family members that smoke. Everybody knows someone that smokes. But I get it. It's at the same time, that's the thing. I get it. I've smoked before, and it's, like, enjoyable. Why? Why is it fun to smoke cigarettes? Humans are dumb.
But, yeah, the filter actually on this cigarette is not too big, considering...
Oh, I'm dying. I am dying.
Hey, go back to where you came from. Holy shit!
was shooting me.
The gang task force better send us a thank you for this. Even more Vagos.
Yeah,
coming
out the way. Gonna die. There's like nobody there. That was my fault.
It's such a complex thing. It's like more often than not, we know what's good and we know what's bad, but when we're offered something that will give us immediate gratification in the short term, but we know there's laid negative consequences, we almost always take the immediate gratification because that's what humans do. And Nick the Smoker seems like a down-to-earth, genuine guy, which is hard to find on YouTube with all the bullshit being shoved down our throat, and the YouTube recommended to find someone.
Yes, restart.
Or a puff of a cigarette. But it's just, I was just intrigued by him, the fact that he built his channel and his community around this niche that is kind of controversial in this day and age. But he seems like a good dude. And I gotta be honest, after watching 15 years of this guy, his cigarettes, just inhaling the scent of tobacco and that sweetness and searching for the best body he can find on his long darts.
All right.
I was overwhelmed. Started to feel like this.
Dude, okay, dude. All right, you gonna blow me up in the process.
We'll leak this.
this to a sympathetic reporter, and they'll get fingered for the breakup. Now clear the area and clear up any stray traffickers you encounter.
Yeah. That's definitely some Kim Kardashian thickness to the body on these. Brilliant. That's easily 9 out of 10, maybe 9.5 if I'm having a good day. All right, guys.
Thanks for
watching.
Before 8 p.m., that is an absolute bollocks. I'll wait for your answer. Do it because they don't exist. Now, I'm not 100% sure, but I think that his TV show may have been canceled, even. But fortunately for us, a lot of these daytime television shows are syndicated to YouTube with all of these clips from the show, and it gives us ample opportunity to watch some of these clips together.
I feel like I just don't understand the female protocol.
You what?
I don't understand the protocol of women, of dating. I feel like I'm a Samsung trying to get into an iPhone plug. I just don't understand it.
You see what I mean? These clips are just magnificent. I mean, you grab these three dudes who have never seen a naked woman outside of their web browser. You get them on the Steve Harvey Show. You get Steve to teach them how to swoon these ladies back to the crib so they can give them a little tour of their anime collection before laying some nerd pipe. It's magnificent.
What about you, Charlie?
I can't read girls. I don't know what they're thinking, or, and then I overthink what they may be thinking, and it goes south quick.
Okay. Time out, Steve. I got this one. Charlie, listen. What you gotta do is learn how to turn your swagger up to an 11. And fortunately, my friend, I have just the thing for you, because today's video
sponsored by Dollar Shave Club. Now, if you're a Leon Lush veteran, you know that I've been working with Dollar Shave Club for quite a time, and not only do I use and stand by their products, but I also appreciate them as a company because they support YouTubers like myself while allowing me to be myself while I'm doing these integrations, and not a lot of companies do that. Now, I'm sure by now you know they offer really quality razors and shaving products, but what you may not have known is they also have a whole line of products to help you stay fresh. Oral care products, hair styling products, shower products, butt wipes, skin products. They have it all, man, and it's all delivered to your doorstep at an affordable price. Right now, they're offering their shave, shower, and oral care starter sets for just $5 each. The shave kit includes their executive razor with backup cartridges and the Dr. Carver shave butter. Now, I personally use these products to do my lineups, and I think they're fantastic, and I'm not just saying that because they're paying me. I actually use them, and I love them. They also recently sent me their oral care starter kit featuring their Superba toothbrush and peppermint kick toothpaste, which left my mouth feeling fresh as a motherfucker after using. So the products are great. You never run out because you decide how often they send you refills, and the more you buy, the more you save. You can join the club today with one of their starter sets for just $5. After that, the restock box ships regular-sized products at a regular price. This offer's available for you guys through my link, dollarshaveclub.com/LeonLush, which you can find in the description down below or in the pinned comment at the top of the comment section. Thank you guys so much for listening.
Incoming.